thank you for being with us today. Meet General Banerjee. I would just like to ask you a few questions and your opinions on humanitarian situations in this experience. So what are the key challenges for states and societies, do you think, in the Asia-Pacific in disaster management? Perhaps maybe could you speak about your experience in India?
Well, the whole Asia-Pacific is especially vulnerable to a whole range of natural and artificial man-made disasters. And therefore, the whole question of humanitarian assistance in disaster relief becomes a very important and a key element in the policy options of all countries in the Asia-Pacific. It is at the center of many of the governments now currently thinking.
So how have the different layers perhaps of Indian society, communities, governments and private sectors developed in humanitarian activities?
Well, let me come back to the recent times. In 2005, the Indian government became one of the few governments in the world which passed a National Disaster Management Act. Now this is an act of parliament which has all constitutional provisions for its implementation. This set up at the apex level, at the national level, the National Disaster Management Authority. It's chaired by the Prime Minister. It's got a full-time dedicated vice chairman, very senior official, perhaps recently retired, perhaps a military official, who is overall in charge of the execution. Under that, each of the provinces of India has a state disaster management authority. Similar lines to the chief minister elected by the people and his head and a separate administrative in charge for looking after. And this structure goes right down to the district level, where there are two co-chairs. One is a senior government official in charge of the district, and the other is a democratically elected head of the district. So this constitutes the core element. They are assisted by members who support these committees. In addition, the organization goes right down to the village level, where of course there is no formal structure, but nevertheless, the communities and the people are involved in providing disaster relief to whenever any disaster strikes the country.
So in your opinion, what do you think are the key elements that we need to develop a more robust humanitarian system?
You know, all such assistance really starts at the community level. The community level, communities have to agree that this is an important element of governance. And so therefore, in that governance, it is just not a responsibility of the officials in the government establishments, but the community as a whole. Fortunately, India is a remarkably diverse country in the world. All the religions that we can think of, all different types of ethnic people. But in the communities in South Asia, like in other parts of the world, each of these communities have a certain belief, a certain acceptance of a certain responsibility that providing assistance to those who are disaster affected is a religious responsibility. So it becomes a community responsibility in the first case to provide assistance. So the community then assists the state structure in providing assistance for disaster relief or any type of humanitarian assistance that is required. So the state really needs to build on that, needs to build on the community, on the people's sentiments and also the people's acceptance that this is a responsibility that they have to share.
Well, thank you very much, Major General Banerjee, for your answers. And thank you very much for joining us here in Singapore this week for our consortium and for the HADF.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure taking part in these discussions. And let's take this whole process forward as we go along.
Thank you.